Magnitude 4.9 quake hit about 45 miles southwest of Palmer, Alaska, shortly before 7:30 this morning. Thousands of people all the way in Anchorage felt the quake, but fortunately, it did no damage and no one was hurt. If your home is damaged in an earthquake, your homeowner's insurance probably will not cover it. Still, fewer than a third of the homeowners in Western Washington have earthquake insurance. If you're thinking about getting some, you might have to wait a few days. Most insurance companies declare a short moratorium on new sales in the aftermath of an earthquake. If all this talk about earthquakes has you thinking it's time to check out your earthquake kit and check up on it, we can help. We've put together a free earthquake survival guide. Just send us a self-addressed stamped envelope here to KOMO TV. Our address is on the screen, 100 4th Avenue North, Seattle, and the zip code 98109 has information you need to make an earthquake plan for your family.
The city of Bellingham has hired an environmental attorney in an attempt to get Olympic Pipeline Company to pay for damage from the pipeline explosion. The city also wants to dictate how and where the pipeline will be rebuilt. Meantime, Bellingham residents are getting a first-hand look at the explosion zone. Each tour began with a 30-second moment of silence, the same amount of time it took for the fire to race through Whatcom Creek after a gas leak ignited. The blast sent smoke 5 miles into the air and killed 3 people.
Well, I used to visit that hole when I was 10 years old, and it was so pristine and so lush down there, and just to see it in that state, it was pretty devastating.
The city has built a trail and several outlook points throughout the blast area, which will be open to the public in about 3 weeks. A KOMO 4 follow-up. Accused wife beater Victor David should be kept behind bars because he's dangerous to others. That's the conclusion of a psychologist assigned to the case. David is being held in the Snohomish County Jail right now. He's charged with second-degree assault after he allegedly spent years beating and starving his wife on board a sailboat. A hearing on his competency is set for later this month.
For local news now, 2 people are dead after a car hit a transit bus head-on in Olympia. Tonight we know that the victims are a 4-year-old boy and his grandfather. Police say their car crossed the center line and hit the inner-city transit bus. No one on the bus was hurt. No serious injuries in this crash landing tonight near Auburn. The Cessna went down a couple of miles south of the Emerald Downs racetrack. The pilot says his engine failed after takeoff from the Auburn airport. This Mountlake Terrace auto repair shop and several cars went up in flames this afternoon. Firefighters say mechanics were working on a gas tank when it fell to the ground and blew up. One man was burned, not badly. He's in satisfactory condition at Harborview Medical Center.
Still a lot of hot spots, but a wildfire is no longer threatening homes in the southern part of our state tonight. So far, about 650 acres have burned in Lyle. That's near the Oregon border. 300 firefighters and 3 helicopters battled the blaze for much of the day. Firefighters hope to have the fire contained by tomorrow night. A children's parade in Coeur d'Alene, Idaho, had an unusual addition today. Anti-Aryan activists. Before the kids' parade, opponents of the Aryan Nation handed out dozens of anti-Nazi leaflets to parents and families. Some people applauded the anti-Nazi demonstration, but others think a celebration for children is no place for any racial conflict.
It's for kids. It's not nothing that they need to be around or associated with, I don't think.
I've never seen anything as blatant as this, as the bigotry that goes on up here.
About 80 members of the Aryan Nations, a neo-Nazi sect, is holding an annual convention at its headquarters in nearby Hayden, Idaho. And the battle lines are drawn in Enumclaw tonight. White supremacists there are gearing up for a white power rally tomorrow. And protesters are getting ready for a demonstration of their own. The planned event has many in Enumclaw up in arms. Some say the residents should just ignore the rally, but others say ignoring hate is the worst thing you can do.
Because when this kind of racism, this kind of bigotry is being promoted, if there aren't voices that are being spoken against it, if there aren't voices that are being raised against it, then it becomes uncontested and there's silent approval of it.
The White Pride rally is tomorrow afternoon. Police and firefighters say everyone on staff will either be working or on call, just in case. A Jewish group is offering a big reward following a string of drive-by shootings in Chicago.
That's because police think the shootings were motivated by racial hatred. Police say a white man drove around Chicago last night firing a gun in at least 8 locations. Former college basketball coach Ricky Birdsong was killed. 6 Orthodox Jews were wounded and an Asian American couple were fired at.
The man who admitted to killing his own infant son to get back at his wife may have had another motive besides revenge. The suspect had reportedly taken out a $100,000 life insurance policy on the boy before his death.
There has been a tornado tonight in Michigan. The storm downed trees and power lines and caused severe damage to several homes and a church. No word of serious injuries, though, but there are a number of people without power right now. This week, the state of Massachusetts found a new weapon in its efforts to control guns and reduce gun violence. Massachusetts' highest court ruled the state can regulate firearms under consumer protection regulations.
The ruling by the Massachusetts court clears the way for the nation's first use of consumer safety protections to regulate firearms.
I think it will serve as a benchmark for other states and hopefully for the federal government to ultimately regulate the gun industry.
Handguns are exempt from federal safety regulations that cover other products, but now, for the first time, a handgun sold in Massachusetts will be treated like any other consumer product. The new regulation will require guns sold in Massachusetts to be equipped with child safety devices, ban the sale of firearms prone to accidental discharge, and require safety warnings to accompany some models of handguns sold in the state. Guns made by the nation's largest manufacturers may already meet these requirements, but cheaper, easier to get Saturday night specials, the guns most often used in crimes, do not. The gun industry this week responded to the court's ruling, saying, "This decision is a surprise and a concern. The regulations fail to enhance and in some instances impair consumer safety." Former State Attorney General Scott Harshberger, who drafted the regulations, disagrees.
We regulate in this country toy pistols, we regulate aspirin bottle caps and teddy bears, but only guns are exempt from broad consumer protection regulation.
And the ruling in Massachusetts this week may only be the beginning. There's a bill to regulate guns under federal consumer protection laws now working its way through Congress.
From salmonella to hepatitis A, unsafe food can spread serious bacteria.
That's why we have strict laws governing food in this country. But how safe are imports? The story coming up in Health Watch.
Then a little later, it's a hit among teenagers, but it's causing extra work for theater owners. We'll tell you why.
Tomorrow's the big night, and just 5 minutes away, the big forecast. Will it be rain or shine? I'm Greg Todd with a look at your 4th of July weather coming up on KOMO 4 News.
Hundreds of new machines now spinning at the Muckleshoot Casino in Auburn. Of new machines now spinning at the Muckleshoot Casino in Auburn.
Introducing a radically new SUV, the new Nissan X-Terra. Everything you need, nothing you don't.
Okay.
He said okay.
Guys?
He said you guys.
Rock and roll!
Is he up?
Well, eat less fat. At Subway, you could get one of seven sandwiches with 6 grams of fat or less. Subway, the way a sandwich should be.
Man, I think you guys need a new boat.
In Health Watch tonight, new concerns about the safety of imported food. President Clinton has just announced new measures aimed at keeping food from outside this country safe. Here's ABC's Judy Muller with more.
Farmers market in Los Angeles this morning, the produce was pouring in. Tomatoes and mangoes from Mexico, kiwis and apples from New Zealand, pears from Chile. In the last 10 years, the amount of food imported into this country has doubled. Today, President Clinton announced new measures aimed at ensuring that food is safe.
While most importers comply with our regulations, it only takes one bad apple to spoil a whole bunch. Only one shipment of contaminated food to threaten hundreds, even thousands of Americans.
Caroline Smith DeWall was delighted to hear the president's message. Her group has been calling for tougher regulations in this area.
It's salmonella, it's E. coli, it's parasites, it's viruses like hepatitis A. Any of these can cause from mild to serious foodborne illnesses.
The president called for a number of steps, including tighter inspection regulations at the border and prohibiting so-called port shopping, in which importers whose cargo is denied at one port simply introduce it at another.
The knockout blow won't come until Congress actually gives FDA authority to go to foreign countries and make sure the food is being produced under sanitary conditions.
Meanwhile, Americans can rest assured on this holiday weekend that most of the food in this country is quite safe. And to guard against those rare exceptions, forget rare. Cook well done. Judy Muller, ABC News, Los Angeles.
President Clinton is ordering inspectors at American ports to brand all unsafe and rejected food products with the label Refused U.S.
Meat-free meals behind bars. Vegan fare is about to be offered on the menu of the San Francisco jail. The policy change comes after an activist convicted of throwing a pie at the mayor was refused meatless and dairy-free food in jail. County jails in Oregon already offer a vegan menu.
Greg Todd with us. Now, a lot of people are used to rainy 4th of July.
Yeah. Yes. You know that we've been laughing about everyone talking about summer begins on the 5th of July. Well, quit laughing. You can see for yourself on this forecast. It's kind of looking that way. Tomorrow, what's going on? Everyone's got big plans. We'll go through that in just a second. But let's look outside right now. There's a live picture from our KOMO cam of downtown Seattle. What we've got above us right now, just some clouds. Good news is we see a drying trend coming. We'll be telling you about that in just a moment. But here's what we have outside right now. Just cloudy skies, 56 degrees. The current temperature, the wind is calm. The barometer is on the rise at 29.93. And we had some rain today, 0.03 inch. Not much, but there were quite a few clouds around. We had some sun breaks, too. It only warmed us up to 61 degrees, though. Well below that normal of 73 degrees, the record. 1972, 90 degrees. Are we going to see those normal temperatures again anytime soon? But we do have some showers out there still tonight, mostly along southern King County into Pierce County, and some of them have been fairly heavy. We can go in a little bit closer and give you a view of the area down along the King Pierce County line where we're seeing the heavier rainfall. But on the satellite picture, we got good news heading our way. You can see that we've got some clouds overhead, but not a lot more moving our way. The clouds that we're going to have tomorrow, well, there's some moisture in the air. We may see some rain around, but it doesn't look like it's going to be a lot. For tonight, it's going to be a mostly cloudy night out there, maybe a few showers around with a low temperature of 50 degrees in Seattle, 46 at Bremerton. Bellevue, you'll have a low tonight, around 48 degrees, may see a scattered shower. But here's KOMO's exclusive time-lapse forecast for tomorrow, the 4th of July. We're seeing some improvement here. It's going to be mostly cloudy to start out the day, and we'll have some showers in there. But as the day goes on, things are looking quite a bit better. We do have a chance of showers tomorrow, but I think the best chance of them will be during the morning hours. As we get into the afternoon, things are going to clear up. We're going to see more sunshine, high temperature, better than today, 65 degrees. We're not at normal just yet, but we're getting there. And there could be a couple of scattered showers around. You know, the best chance of seeing them tomorrow will be out towards the Cascade foothills, right around Puget Sound. Probably going to have sunshine during the afternoon hours. Down at Olympia, about 67 degrees, 68 at Portland, the low 60s out on the coast. And up north, you'll see some showers around, especially during the morning hours as well tomorrow, with 61 degrees at Port Angeles and Mount Vernon, 62 at Everett. In the Cascades, the freezing level is at 5,500 feet. And in eastern Washington, cooler than normal, but getting better, 72 degrees at Wenatchee, 75 at Yakima, and 65 at Spokane. Now, there is heat out there and a lot of it in the southwest. Vegas and Phoenix will be over 100 degrees, and the heat continues on east. Dallas, 96. Albuquerque, 94 degrees. But as you go further east, they're mixing it with humidity and just making conditions miserable. Chicago, 96. Kansas City, 94 degrees. It'll be 98 degrees and humid in Washington, D.C. tomorrow. For us, though, it's just going to be mostly cloudy around here tonight with some light rain at time. Temperatures dropping from the mid-40s to around 50 degrees overnight. Tomorrow morning, look for some scattered showers around. Otherwise, it's going to be mostly cloudy during the morning hours. As we get into the afternoon, things are getting better. It's going to be clearing. We've got drier and warmer conditions for tomorrow afternoon. The sunset tomorrow is at 9:10. Fireworks begin about 10 o'clock. It'll be dark by then. Our afternoon highs tomorrow. And that six-day forecast as well. Look at Monday, the 5th of July. Morning clouds, afternoon sunshine, 72 degrees. Let's declare that summer. It gets better on Tuesday. We may see a little bit of morning rain around on Wednesday, but Thursday and Friday, looking good. I'd say around fireworks time tomorrow night, plan on some clouds out there. It doesn't look real good for rain.
Well, that's good.
That's real good.
I'd like to hear that.
Yeah.
And, about time? I tell you, every year, July 5th, it happens every single year.
We won't know till tomorrow night, though, but that's what we think.
All right, thanks, Craig.
Up next, the Mariners make an inspiring comeback in Texas.
But will the bullpen do their part and preserve the lead? Bruce King is here after the break.
Someone's masking their true identity. Can Rosie name the mystery guest?
Are you Dolly Parton?
A little smaller in the chest area.
Did the mystery guest play fair? Plus the surprising Sarah Jessica Parker. Next, Rosie.
It's the summertime. Take it easy watching Rosie. It's the time.
Monday at 4 on KOMO ABC4.
It's Toyota's 4th of July Savings Spectacular, and your Toyota dealer's leading the way to 1.8 financing on nearly every new Toyota. 1.8 on Camry, America's number one selling car for 2 years in a row. 1.8 on Corolla, and 1.8 on all Tacoma pickups. Even 1.8 on 4Runner, RAV4, and the all-new Camry Solara. But hurry, these savings end July 6th. See your Western Washington Toyota dealer, leading the way to value.
I need to talk to you about something.
Is it dessert?
It's ready.
The practice, Sunday at 9, followed by 4th of Julyvers on KOMO ABC4.
Hundreds of new machines now spinning at the Muckleshoot Casino in Auburn. Of new machines now spinning at the Muckleshoot Casino in Auburn.
Help you?
King size, please.
How much?
30, 40, 15 bucks. 15!
Plus the 20, right?
The 20!
Oh, man. Oh, man.
Now there's a better way to get money. GetSmart.com. Check us out on the web.
I do about 70,000 miles a year in this car, and I go through a lot of tires. My name is Louis LeBove, and I drive this cab for a living. I'm also a volunteer fireman. I use this cab to get the fires. Whenever I have to spend money on this car, it comes out of my pocket.
He's a top-of-the-line Goodyear. They got him at Walmart. They got BF Goodyear. They got Michelin.
That's where I got him, right there. I sent my daughter in there for tires and oil changes. I know they'll treat her right. They got name-brand tires and oil and great prices.
For the Walmart Tire and Lube Store, come around to the back door.
How you gonna beat that?
Sunday on KOMO 4 News. Can you believe these people have MS? A local woman's fight with a crippling disease leads to an amazing discovery.
I can walk again. I can talk again.
Sunday at 11 on KOMO 4 News.
Bruce is here now. For a while, this wasn't looking good.
Oh, yeah, but if you're a Mariner fan tonight, you're smiling. You like this one. In one of the biggest comebacks in franchise history, the Mariners defeat the Texas Rangers 13-12. To break a three-game losing streak. Down 6-0 in the fourth, Alex Rodriguez hits this shot down the line and left for a home run to get the Mariners on the scoreboard. Then with the Rangers leading 9-2 in the fifth, the bases loaded, Ken Griffey Jr. hits this drive into the gap in left center. The ball will roll to the wall. Three runs score on the play to get the Mariners right back in it. Then in the sixth, two outs, Rodriguez singles to left, driving in David Bell, who had triple to tie the game at 9-9. The Mariners then grab the lead in the seventh. Russ Davis goes deep to left for a home run with two on.
with the Mariners up by three. Then in the eighth, with the Mariners still on top, 12-11, Rodriguez gets his second home run of the night. He drives the ball deep into the stands and left as the Mariners hold on to win it, 13-12. Turning to tennis, Pete Sampras, Andre Agassi will play for the Wimbledon men's singles title tomorrow in the first All-American final since 1993. Semifinal play today. Pete Sampras in the far court serving to Britain's Tim Henneman. As Sampras, the defending champion, wins in four sets to advance to the finals where he owns a 13-10 record against Andre Agassi. Agassi now in a position to become the number one player in the world, win or lose tomorrow. In his battle with two-time U.S. Open champion Patrick Rafter, Agassi wins in three sets. He tries to become the first man since 1990 to win the French Open and Wimbledon back-to-back as he wins at match point. On the women's side, Steffi Graf in the far court against Mariana Lucci, with Lucci winning the first set, but from then on it was all Graf. She serves at match point. Steffi Graf winning and advancing as she goes after her 23rd Grand Slam title. Then Lindsay Davenport, on her way to another number one ranking, puts away the qualifier, Alexandria Stevenson. The match lasts just 48 minutes. Davenport wins in straight sets, 6-1 and 6-1. In golf, Siri Pak is tied with Shani War and Ginny Ledbeck for the third round lead in the Jamie Farr Kroger Classic. Christy O'Connor is three shots in front of the field in the State Farm Senior Classic. And caddy Garland Dempsey collapsed in the 15th hole of the Western Open today. Rushed to the hospital. Garland, the caddy for John McGinnis, listed in critical but stable condition. It was over 90 degrees in the course when he collapsed. Through three rounds of play, Tiger Woods is a four-shot lead in the field as he rolls in this long birdie putt on 16 on his way to a four-under par 68. Sahali's Rick Fair is eight back with just four shots out of second place. And finally, we go back to baseball for our play of the night, the Cubs and the Phillies in the fifth inning. Sammy Sosa nails this Paul Byrd pitch to deep center for his major league leading 31st home run of the season. After finishing second to Mark McGwire last year, Sosa is now the man in charge, and that's worth our play of the night.
But McGwire's not far behind, is he?
Not that far behind. No, he has 23.
So it's going to be interesting to see what happens.
It certainly will be. In soccer, Brazil against the United States Women's World Cup play tomorrow. Semifinals at Stanford Stadium. Going to be something.
Yes, thanks, it will. Bruce. Yes.
We'll have tonight's winning lottery numbers coming up next.
We'll also tell you why this movie is pitting some local teens against theater owners.
The signs are in place, but who's paying attention? Will a lower alcohol limit reduce drunk driving? One drink, two drinks. What does it take to ruin your life? Town Meeting exposes who's driving drunk. Sunday at 6 on KOMO, ABC 4.
With GTE prepaid wireless, there's never a monthly bill to worry about. So you can finally stop wrestling with yourself over whether to get a wireless phone. $69.95 gets you started with a phone and talk time. Call 1-800-800-4-GTE. Wireless system supplied by Motorola.
1, 2, 3, 4! Yeah! Yeah, that's
right! Right now, when you buy a top-quality Exide NASCAR Select battery from Shucks, you'll get a new pager free. And this month only, Pennzoil is just 89 cents a quart with coupon and case purchase. More brands, more parts. Shucks, the place to start for parts.
Interrupt this commercial to bring you another commercial.
Cool.
You can now get free Advantage.
Free? Wow.
That's right, baby. Buy 8 tubes of Advantage from your vet and get 1 tube free.
Advantage rocks.
It's awesome. Now back to our other commercial.
And it kills those fleas with ease. It's fast. Advantage kills the fleas. Advantage kills the fleas. Get it from your vet.
Chevrolet cars are trusted by more Americans than any other. Chevy trucks are the most dependable, longest lasting on the road. If that's not enough reason to own a Chevrolet car or truck, then this definitely is. The Great Summer Drive-In from Chevrolet. You can drive away in a select Chevrolet and get cash back up to $2,000, or choose APR financing as low as 0% for 36 months. Or check out the offers on other great Chevrolet cars and trucks. It's Chevrolet's Great Summer Drive-In. See your local Chevrolet dealer today.
Know how to use egg whites to erase wrinkles, or which color will always make you look your best? Next Northwest Afternoon Makeovers with actress Mary Lou Henner. Plus, how knowing if you're a warrior or a visionary can help you lose weight.
Monday at 3.
And you might want to grab those lottery tickets. Winning numbers are on your screen. There they are. 2, 4, 9, 10, 30, and 45. No one won the $9 million lotto jackpot.
The winning hand for Quinto. Now on your screen, 4 of hearts, 2 of hearts, ace of diamonds, queen of diamonds, and 4 of clubs. No one had this hand, so the top prize goes to $1.3 million for Wednesday night's drawing.
What about Lucky for Life? 16, 50, 73, and 95, and no one won for the lifetime either, $50,000 or $25,000 Lucky for Life jackpots. The movie South Park is proving the biggest test yet to theater owners' recent agreement with President Clinton to strictly enforce the R rating.
I'm sorry, I can't help myself. That movie has warped my fragile little mind.
Yes, yes, I saw the Terrence and Phillip movie.
No, it was
in the movie South Park, kids sneak into an R-rated movie, then the kids learn about raunchy things we can't even repeat here. Now, real-life local kids are trying to gain a similar education. Everett Nine Cinemas report that starting on opening day last Wednesday, teens under 17 have been trying to sneak into South Park. So, ticket sellers and ushers are now checking IDs multiple times.
Anyone here very surprised about that?
No.
I think it's just the thrill of it, right?
KOMO 4 News back tomorrow morning at 8 and 9 a.m. Have a great 4th of July.
Good night.
Good night. Good night.
Winner of the Emmy for Outstanding Daily Newscast. Thanks for watching KOMO 4 News, first for local news. Fisher Broadcasting.